I'm Anthony F. Elmore here to bring you another exciting Black Buddhist Lecture. My lecture today is the world's smoothest, coolest Buddhist. Now, let me be clear. We do not desire to be like some Asian monk on a mountain meditating. In fact, that is not Buddhism. That is Asian culture. My dream in life is to be a proud Black Buddhist. The tragic thing about the Buddhist religion is the fact that while Buddhism was created by a Black man, Shakyamuni Buddha, and all of the people of ancient India were Black people who practice Buddhism follow Asians and Buddhism, and they stop being Black. We practice the Buddhist teachings as taught by the 13th century Black Japanese Buddhist sage, Nichiren Shonin. Now, Nichiren Shonin taught his disciples by way of letters. These letters are called the Gosho, and this is how he taught his disciples. Now, there is a Gosho titled The Expedient Means and the Lifespan Chapters. Now, this Gosho explains how we proud Black Buddhists, or how we Black people, should practice Buddhism. Now, in the Gosho, and again, it's called the Lifespan, it's called Expedient Means and Lifespan Chapters. And it reads, quote, "When we scrutinize the sutras and treaties with care, we find that there is a teaching about a precept known as following the customs of the region that corresponds to this. The meaning of this precept is that so long as no seriously offensive act is involved, even if one were to depart to some slight degree from the teachings of Buddhism, it would be better to avoid going against the manners and customs of the country. This is a precept expounded by the Buddha. It appears that some wise men who are unaware of this point." Unquote. You see, imagine, ladies and gentlemen, the Buddha taught that we should practice Buddhism according to the customs of a region. If I was living in Japan, I would practice like Japanese. Now, in my particular case, I live in Memphis, Tennessee, the soul capital of the world. It is in Memphis, Tennessee, where the late Grammy Award winner Isaac Hayes and my friend David Porter, these friends of mine, wrote a song in Memphis called Soul Man. You see, ladies and gentlemen, in the African American community, we, when it comes to singing and dancing, all of America's original music and song and dance were created by Black people. Now, in Detroit, they had that smooth Motown sound. And in Philadelphia, they had that Philadelphia sound. But we in Memphis, Tennessee had Stax. We had that soul of that gritty sound. You see, this is the custom of us in Memphis, Tennessee. Now, when it comes to Buddhism, we do not practice Buddhism like Asians. We don't sing songs like the SGI Buddhist organization sang a horrible song called Sensei, "Will You Worship This Man by the Name of Daisaku Kato?" We don't sing songs like that. You see, in the Gosho, that's titled On Repaying Debts of Gratitude. And it reads, quote, "In a scripture called the Nirvana Scripture Sutra, the Buddha says, quote, rely on the law and not upon persons. Relying on the law here means relying on various sutras, not relying on persons means not relying on persons other than the Buddha, such as Bodhisattvas, Universal Worthy, Mojutra, or various Buddhist teachers I have enumerated earlier. You see, Nichiren Shonin pointed out that we who practice Buddhism should follow only the words of the Buddha. We should not follow so-called Buddhist leaders, but we should follow the words of the Buddha. As he says, rely on the law and not upon persons. You see, we as proud Black Buddhists never kowtow to any Asian, white man, or anyone other than the Buddha. We should only rely on the words of the Buddha as taught by the Buddha himself. You see, again, it is clear there is a teaching about a precept known as following the customs of the region. You see, we as proud Black Buddhists should practice our faith in conjunction with our African-American culture. You see, some white people have complained to me. I mean, one white lady wrote me and she says, why are you having a proud Black Buddhist set? Don't you know you are causing division? You see, the reason that we do not have the best of America emerging from the Buddhist ranks is a direct result of Buddhism's institutional racism. You see, ladies and gentlemen, in the second century AD, a white Kushan king by the name of Kanishka conquered the people of India. And this white Kushan king separated Buddhism based on race, culture, and language. What this white Kushan king did, he and a Brahman by the name of Ashvaghosha created a new Buddhism based on race, culture, and language. This new Buddhism was called Mahayana Buddhism. Mahayana Buddhism is characterized by the language of the Brahmans called Sanskrit. Sanskrit is a way of which the Brahmans and the white races use this as a way to extricate all Black Buddhists' history, writing, and culture. Not only did they eradicate Black history, Buddhist history, they eradicated all Black Buddhist history, and they came up with a false writings called the Vedas. In the Vedas, they tell a lie about a theory called the Aryan Invasion Theory. No such thing as the Aryan Invasion happened. There was no such thing as happened. Even today, white people who claim to be Aryans base their lie on this fact that they were Aryans. The word Arya comes from the Black language of Pali, which means area, and they came up with a name called Aryan, and white people have believing that they are a superior people based on such falsities. Now, when it comes to the Buddhist religion, whites and Asians ignored the precepts of the Buddha that Buddhism should be taught according to the customs of the region. Now, when it comes to our Black culture, you gotta feel it. There is a scene in a movie called The Five Heartbeats. Now, I want you to see the scene in this movie, and I want the white woman to say, who says we should practice like white people or Asians, I want her to see the scene in the movie of The Five Heartbeats. You see? Now, let me tell you what happened in this scene. You see, they were in a talent show, whereas the piano player was used to sabotage their act because the piano player was not putting soul into the song. Now, the same thing happens with African Americans who practice Buddhism. You see, African Americans are in a situation where you have to practice Buddhism according to Asian culture. And as a result of that, no real significant African-American leaders have evolved from Buddhism because African-Americans do not have cultural expression in Buddhism. You see, we at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association practice Buddhism inclusive of our Black history, culture, and language. And that is what makes us the world's most smoothest and coolest Buddhists. Now, what I want you to do to kind of get an understanding, I want you to see a quick scene from the movie. It's called The Five Heartbeats, and they were at this talent show, and this piano player was not pushing the song in a way to where people can be culturally expressive. So let's watch this scene from the movie, The Five Heartbeats, and we're going to come back and put a period on this quick Buddhist lecture, The World's Smoothest and Coolest Buddhist. Let's watch this scene from The Five Heartbeats.
Come on, duck to the step.
No, it's my music.
And it reads, quote, with regard to the word kyo, profound meaning says, quote, the voice carries out the work of the Buddha, and this is called kyo or sutra. This is how Asians and whites transform Black Buddhists. They transform Black Buddhists by not creating a culture where Black people can be expressive. You see, there's a Go show, it's called, now look this up, it's called On Proper Way to Preach the Doctrine. You see, the proper way to preach the doctrine is to be yourself. be cultured specimen. And this gosher reads, quote, so you have gone to the capital, and before much time has passed, you are changing your name, a piece of utter nonsense. No doubt you have also changed your way of speaking and acquired the accent of the capital, like a mouse that is changed into a bat, but in fact is neither mouse, neither bird, nor mouse. You are neither a country priest nor a priest of the capital. You see, ladies and gentlemen, we who are Buddhists, we cannot change and be no Oriental. We got to be our profound and gracious and great black and positive selves. We should practice Buddhism according to our own black culture. You see, we are black people, and we should express, proudly express our Buddhist faith inclusive of our black culture, history, and language. One thing that you would never see, ladies and gentlemen, Tina Turner, we call her the mother of the proud black Buddhists. Tina Turner would never let an Asian sit in her shadow. People love Tina Turner. People know Tina Turner is a Buddhist, but Tina Turner would never let an Asian sit in her shadow. Tina Turner looks beyond Asians.
Practice does, it helps you to feel better, helps you to think different. If you think different, you think correctly. I would say it helps you to think correctly. So that means you can help yourself get the things you want. Some people say, I was told that I could get things, whether it's a car or a house, which some people need help in that way. Well, of course, because you change an old style of thinking, which is not very smart, that blocks you from getting where you want to get. But once you start putting words in, the same words, it's like typing in good thoughts. Mm. You type it in and you get a whole rollout of good thoughts. Your brain is thinking good thoughts. Your mind is constantly rolling and saying good things. So you think differently, which helps you to get to where you want to get your car, your house, and to feel good. It's really very important what you say, what you think, how often you say it.
That we, and proud black Buddhists, are the world's smoothest, coolest. We are proud black Buddhists. I'm going to take you out on my song, The Coolest and the Smoothest Buddhists. Thank you very much.
Get up! Get up! Get up!
When it comes to religion, I got to be me. I practice religion that makes me free. I don't live by no Ten Commandments. I am no fan of this. I move through time and space and travel intergalactic. My thinking is elastic. When it comes to religion, I'm the coolest, I'm the smoothest, and the cutest, I'm the proud black Buddhist. I don't practice no Asian religion. I would never make such a decision. Just because you are Asian and bald-headed and wear a robe, I'm supposed to be whole. Brother, you got me the mix. I am universal. When it comes to religion, I'm the coolest. I'm the smoothest, cutest, smoothest. I am the proud black Buddhist. Time and space, and space and time, and quad dimension. With limited thinking, I'm with dissension. And me being backwards, don't even mention it. You're trying to control my mind, the way I think. You're trying to put me in a fix. Man, you must got me in the mix. When it comes to religion, I'm the coolest, I'm the cutest, I'm the smoothest, I'm suited to the Buddhist Buddhist. They got some Buddhists called STI, literature. shoe, indigenous show shoe. Some we got single leaders, but my teacher, it's a lot of sutru. Many of the brothers got with the Japanese and lost their swag and stopped being cool. These black brothers follow Japanese rules. Those brothers are Buddhists, and when it comes to the smoothest, and the cutest, and the smoothest, and the most suited, you want to go with that proud black Buddhist. I don't practice Buddhism like my Japanese brother. I practice Buddhism with my own black culture. They call me the elf, and I'm a bad mother. When it comes to Buddhism, you want to know who is the coolest, the smoothest, the cutest, smoothest, and suited Buddhist? Hey, check us out. We're called the Proud Black Buddhist. Now, maybe my style of Buddhism don't suit you. My Buddhist practice is the Lotus Sutra. If the sucker don't like my style, then it's sad. Them chumps don't know everything, and they ain't my dad. If you don't like me, that's your bad karma. And you know what? I don't give a damn, you can go tell your mama. When it comes to the Buddhist teachings, who is the coolest? Tell them suckers, we are the proud black Buddhists. Now, I'm a black brother. And I'm gonna practice Buddhism like a Japanese. Negro, please. I'm the smoothest, I'm the coolest, I'm the cutest, I'm most suited, I'm the proud black Buddhist. Hey y'all, check us out. The coolest, the smoothest, and cutest, suited, booted, and duty. I'm the proud black Buddhist. Y'all check us out.
Go.